Welcome to Cell Clips. In this video, we will be discussing vesicle docking and fusion. Proteins destined for many locations in the cell, such as the cell membrane, endosomes, lysosomes, or outside the cell, must be transported through vesicles. If you saw our video on vesicle budding, you know that vesicles carry cargo proteins from a source membrane to a target membrane. After the vesicle separates from its source membrane, it must be transported to a specific target membrane, tethered to the membrane in a process called docking, and fused with the membrane to deliver its cargo. First, let's take a look at vesicle transport and docking. These processes are mediated by a family of proteins called Rab-GTPases. There are many different Rab proteins, each associated with a specific vesicle or target membrane, to ensure vesicles are brought to the correct location. Rab proteins are abundant in the cytoplasm in their inactive GDP form. GEF proteins in both the source and target membranes activate Rab-GTP, causing it to exchange GDP for GTP. Rab-GTP can then bind membranes. Some Rabs bind to vesicles, while others bind to target membranes. Once membrane-bound, Rab-GTPases recruit proteins called Rab effectors. These effectors come in many different forms and assist in vesicle transport and docking. For example, some Rab effectors recruited by the vesicle-associated Rabs are motor adapters. These proteins form a link between the vesicles and motor proteins that move along cytoskeletal filaments to transport vesicles to their destination. Rab effectors associated with the target membrane, especially tethering factors, mainly assist in docking. Tethering proteins are long filaments that interact with Rab proteins on the vesicle to pull the vesicle toward the target. But bringing the vesicle to the correct target membrane is only half the battle. The real challenge is overcoming the energetically unfavorable process of fusing the vesicle and target membranes. Membranes will only fuse together when they are brought within a few nanometers of each other. This process is accomplished by proteins called snares. Different forms of these proteins are bound to particular membranes and provide additional target specificity. Once the vesicle is docked, a V-snare anchored to the vesicular membrane and two T-snares anchored to the target membrane coil together. For example, in synaptic vesicle fusion, neuronal vesicles are fused with the plasma membrane to deliver neurotransmitters to a neighboring cell. During neuronal vesicle fusion, the T-snare protein SNAP25 forms coiled coils with another T-snare called synaptobrevin and the V-snare syntaxin. In all cases of vesicle fusion, this coiling of snare proteins tightens the gap between vesicle and target membranes, squeezing out any water in between them. Snare coiling releases the energy needed to overcome the repulsion between the polar heads of the two membranes. When the membranes get close enough, hydrophilic heads from each membrane spontaneously flip directions, causing the closest layers of the two membranes to merge together. Spontaneous flipping is the rate-limiting step of vesicle fusion because it forms an unstable, hemifused membrane. Because hemifusion is highly unstable, it quickly rearranges to form a fully fused membrane. Once the vesicle has fused with its target membrane, the cargo is released into the luminal side, and membrane-bound proteins in the vesicle become part of the target membrane. After fusion is complete, the vesicular components, such as V-snares and vesicular Rab-GTPs, need to be released. Rab gaps on the target membrane deactivate vesicular Rab-GTP to form Rab-GDP, which is released into the cytoplasm. The snares present a more difficult problem because they are twisted together in a very stable, low-energy conformation. An ATPase called NSF and several cofactors solve this problem by using energy from ATP hydrolysis to release the snare proteins. This allows V-snares to be recycled to the vesicle source membrane, while T-snares are left in the target membrane, ready to receive the next vesicle. So in summary, after vesicles form, they must be transported, docked, and fused to a target membrane. Rab-GTPs in both the vesicle and target membranes recruit Rab effector molecules, such as motor adapters to transport the vesicles along cytoskeletal elements, and tethering factors to pull the vesicle into a docked position. Once the vesicle is docked, snare proteins in both the vesicle and target membranes coil together, releasing energy and bringing the polar heads of the two membranes closer. In a rate-limiting step, the hydrophilic layers merge together, forming a hemifused membrane that is quickly resolved to a fully fused membrane. Snare complexes are then unwound, and Rab proteins released so the process can be repeated. Well, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching CellClips.